a different way. The sensible data is coming in from the Deutsche Post corporate network, and the system, the information that you are dealing with should be tackled separately anyway. So we thought, okay, hey, we want to get used to Flow, and we wanted to enable the programmers to make a safe system without needing to think about too much about it. So what we did is we said, okay, the corporate data that needs to go into the system will be imported through Flow, the data from SAP, the partner data that we are having, and the user data that is coming in. And so in fact, we saw something like that when we were confronted with all the data that the Deutsche Post wanted to deliver to their clients. It was a lot, it was somehow organized, but in a way that needed to be reorganized as well. So we thought, okay, how can we provide the necessary infrastructure, and how can we deal with the facts that we needed to have a front end within the internet, and that we needed to have a front end in the intranet. So the idea was that Flow infrastructure is solely used on the intranet, because on the internal network, with the internal data, because the NEA system that we wanted to use wasn't already there. There were some prototypes, I would call them right now. The prototypes looked nice, but as you all know, it's only prototypes. And we went in contact with the programmers and asked them, okay, for Flow is there, and we wanted to use Flow in this project, but would you personally use NEOS or the new content management system? And the answer was, oh well, yes, we would use it, it's cool, use it, because it's there and you could use it. And sorry, we then asked some more questions. I got the feeling, well, it's there, and they are really proud of it, and I think we could do it, but something isn't feeling right, and it's too much of a big project, so we do not want to put too many risks in it. So I was asking the programmers from the core team, I would say the $1 million question, saying, okay, fine, if we are going to use Flow NEOS and the new CMS, would you give us €1 million if the project fails because of NEOS, not because of us? They gave some thoughts to it, and 2 years ago, the simple answer was, well, use Type 3. Type 3 is ready for your purposes, and Flow NEOS is not. But again, use Flow, it's solid enough, and it works with Type 3 and will support you in a way that it could be useful in your project. So the decision was taken, and we set up our infrastructure, which basically looked like this. We had the zone of least trust, which is the internet. We have the zone of highest trust, which is the corporate network. And we had something that is here, it's the corporate data, where the only way from the corporate data was through a middle zone, that the information from the corporate data is coming in and processed through our Flow system and then delivered to the shared database server. Because the Deutsche Post didn't want to have all informations in the internet, and they didn't want to have all informations in the corporate network as well, for whatever reasons. So what we were faced were that we had this middle zone where we have all the information, and the information is split up so that it could be used in the corporate network, the necessary information, and could be used in the internet as well. So the question that could arise is that you say, okay, why did you use Flow at all? And as I said, Flow itself helped us a lot to make sure that we are dealing with sensitive data, because the only way, if you look at it, where the sensitive data comes in and is provided is in that area. This is where the corporate data comes in, and then it's processed through Flow. So this is the part where we needed to be as careful as possible. And if you're using a different system, as a programmer, you're at least aware that the system you're dealing with is important. So it was a mental help. The other thing is that I do not want to hide the information, that when it comes to security, it's security is one divided by comfort. And trust me, getting all the data in a correct way from the corporate side into the system wasn't easy at all. It wasn't comfortable. You always had to think about where are we allowed to deliver the data, what are we allowed to do with the data, and so it helped us in that area as well. What also helped a lot for sure was the direct access to the Flow programming team, and we could persuade the Deutsche Post using Flow, because we said, hey, it's already in use with Rossmann and Amadeus, and so it's not that much of a risk. We wanted to take the risk, and we see many opportunities, and so it wasn't the wrong decision for us. So we used Flow in that area for processing the corporate data, but we used Flow in another area as well, as an internal authentication provider for our BAUS systems, for the internet and the intranet when the people log in. So what Flow is doing in this whole system as well is providing the user authentication, and now 2 years after, we are also implemented an OpenID server, so that now other system can authenticate against our partner network through TYPO3 and use the authentication that we implemented. So basically Flow is used in that project in a high security area, and I personally think it was the right decision, because as Robert and Carsten said yesterday, Flow is laid out to make things easy for you. And the part of doing things easy, Flow does things easy the right way. So it's hard to do things wrong, to forget that the data is sensitive, and this is where Flow helped us being on the track and delivering the quality that was needed in that project. Again, what I said, what we are dealing with was the user data coming in from many different systems, and the SSP system itself looked first to be the biggest problem, but then we could strip it down to getting imports, because the SIP system itself wasn't accessible in a way we needed it, because of the setup of the Deutsche Post, of the underlying network policy they had. There was no allowance to contact SIP directly, the SIP systems. And on the other hand, when we had the chance to use it, it wasn't fast enough, because it wasn't meant to be accessible by so many users. It was more doing somehow batch processing system. So the SIP data basically is coming in through some importers that do the imports on a regular basis, most of them in the nights, and others on a on a schedule that the Deutsche Post can live with and that works with us. So what helped us a lot in that project was the flow philosophy, and I was talking about this with Sebastian Kurfürst, and he said the unit and functional testing is the point that where flow is making the most efforts to support this, and the other areas where they are deeply in and wanted to help the developers is the logging thing. So everything that you wanted to be logged can be logged because the functions are already there. So if you have a problem digging into problems, either performance problems or weird accesses that you see in your system, you can turn on the logging. And this is in fact on the performance side what we needed a couple of times, and Sebastian helped us along the way, and now we are able to do this on our own. The other things that Flow is providing you is persistence and configuration that's laid out very solid, and if you have seen the talk from Robert and Sebastian yesterday, then you know that it's very easy because you only need a very few amount of lines of code to configure things and to access things. So in those four areas, Flow is a good way to use, but much more important for us was the Flow package management. Because if you have so many packages or features to deliver to the system, even if it's through Type 3, you have to find a way how you deliver them. And we were using Flow in those areas with the Flow Serve deployment, so that we are now able to deploy very small packages, as you see here, when it's needed when it's needed from the Deutsche Post. So the important part that we are using is the Flow Serve that helped us a lot to implement the continuous delivery. And if you see, it was totally new for the Deutsche Post to have new installations up and running within 1 hour, and mostly without interrupting the system. I remember the first times when they said, yeah, okay, when is the next release? And we were something asking, like, what next release are you meaning? They say, yeah, when is the next time the new features will come on? We basically said, well, any time you wanted to have. Ah, no, that's not going to work, they said. We need to have a schedule, and we need to make sure that everything works. And I was saying, well, we are pretty sure that everything works, and if something fails, we can always go back to the system as it was before if we have access to the server, so there's no big issue. Yeah, well, we somehow believe you, but we don't think that's going to work. Anyway, after now working with them for 2 years, they are somehow more relaxed. And instead of asking us for when is the next release, we are more or less talking about new configuration of the system. For sure, underlying there's PHP code that we put in the system, but they understand that we can continuously deliver new features without breaking the old features. And this is, in that project, to the Deutsche Post, one of the things that they learned, that the agile development helps them a lot to move along faster in their project and to deliver in smaller pieces without having the hassle always to having a big deployment. So this is where Type 3 Serve for Flow and for Type 3 helped us a lot. But I do not want to hide some issues that we had at the beginning, really. The smallest issue that we have was that the documentation wasn't optimal at all 2 years ago. So we had to open some boxes, dig into some things, and then we found some bigger issues that we said, And we, as you all know, about 2 years ago, the performance of Flow wasn't that that great, because the focus from the programming team was totally different. They put the focus on security, and security was well done, but performance wasn't that optimal. But that changed as well. And the bigger problems that we have was that the memory consumption with all the objects that we had in memory by importing the data was quite big. And as you all start with a small set of data, because you're basically not allowed to use the real data, so you have to do your own data, and there's always not enough time to give thoughts to real data and how they look like. When we started the real imports into the system, we quickly noticed that we are running out of memory. But as we had enough tests, Daniel really fixed the problem in a very short time, so that at the end, after changing some lines of code in our system, the memory issue wasn't there at all. But again, those were problems that arised during the journey. Some were Flow specific, but the team was very helpful, and the Flow team was very helpful. Some issues were homemade and homegrown, some were from the project, but it wasn't a big deal to get along with the issues and to sort them all out and to find ways around it. So at the end of the project, we opened all those little boxes and all the little problems and digged into them, find a solution, and found a way around it. So the killer question to is, would we do it again? To sum it up, Flow really did the job that it promised to do. The continuous delivery that we implemented and that we could use from Flow back those days worked the way, and the continuous deployment as well. And the biggest thing that in my company at Punkt.de changed was, in my opinion, the way how we are dealing with code. You all know your programmers when they talk about Type 3, that you can do basically everything with it, but you also do not want to do everything with it, because sometimes it feels clumsy, sometimes it doesn't help you a lot, sometimes you have to get around the system that is working. And the Flow system was so much more of an ease to use in that area, because it helped you to do things the right way and not to do things in the wrong way that that you are somehow used to do through Type 3. So the basic thing that happened is that the overall code quality raised dramatically. And the biggest thumbs up that we got from the Deutsche Post was that they digged into all of our code that we delivered with their internal systems, and they basically said, well, they never have had such a good code quality. Usually with those, I think it was 150,000 lines of codes that they dig into, they found around 5 to 6%, and then it's good code. 5 to 6% of wrong coding lines, to word it that way. And in that project, they only found 0.5%, so half of a percent of coding bugs they found, and they were easily they could easily be solved from us. So what they said, they never had such a good code quality, and I personally think that has a lot to do with the Flow that we used, with the techniques that Flow implemented and forced us to use, and for sure with the team that we had at Punkt.de that adapted very quickly to the new technologies. And so if you ask me, would you do it again? It's a definite yes. We like the project. We are still working with the Deutsche Post, and Deutsche Post likes the project as well. The next couple of years are planned how to improve the system and how we can provide them their needs, and they are endless ideas what the partner network could do for them. So I really want to encourage you all, if you are either a programmer or a CEO of a company or somebody that can make decisions, to try out Flow as early as possible, not only in those internal projects where some people are sitting around and just doing little things and are distracted by the daily business, but take the chance and use Flow in client projects. Have a look at it. The Flow NEOS team is very helpful, and from what I've seen yesterday in the talk from Robert and Sebastian, and later on in the talk from Erasmus, I think the whole ecosystem of Flow will be the next big system that helps us all delivering really, really, really cool websites to our clients in a really, really nice quality. So I highly recommend, if you weren't at the talks from Robert and Sebastian, take a chance and have a look at them when they are uploaded. And the NEOS UX talk from Rasmus is really worth looking at it. Also the quotes that he got from other people from the industry, they really like what I've seen right now with Flow and NEOS, and I would really highly recommend taking more than just a look at the system and try to see the new chances that give Flow and NEOS to you. Yeah, that's all about our journey through Flow. Are there any questions? No questions at all, so I want to say thank you and enjoy the rest of the conference.